Welcome to Champion Minded, the podcast for those who aim for excellence, not only in the sports arena, but in life. My name is Allistair McCaw, author, speaker, mindset and performance coach, and my goal is to help you unleash your unlimited potential and provide you with the tools to achieve greatness. Are you ready to become champion minded? Then let's do this. Hey everybody, welcome to the Champion Minded podcast, or welcome back to it. I'm Allistair McCaw, your host, coming to you from the Netherlands this week. I'm on to my sixth week here in Europe. It's been an incredibly successful trip with a lot of meetings, presentations, consulting. But looking forward to heading back home on Friday, back to Florida. It's going to be a sauna there, especially this time of the year in July. But anyway, in this week's episode, we have the five keys to a champion-minded performance. And I'm talking about what the very best athletes and players do when they compete. Because especially at the highest level, they all put in the time, they all put in the hours, the practice. However, those champion-minded performers, those elite performers, do certain things differently. And you might not see them, you know, when you observe them or you watch them on TV or whatever it may be, you don't see those smaller little details. And that's something that in my profession, I've invested a lot of time and a lot of years in, is seeing those small little details, the things that can be so easily passed over by us that we don't see. The little superstitions, the little rituals, the things they do in between practices or after practices or even sometimes during the competition. So I'm going to share these five keys, or we can even call them five secrets, of what the champion-minded performers do when they compete. So are you ready for this one? Let's do it. Okay, number one. They have a prepper readiness routine. I'll say that again. They have a prepper readiness routine. Now, if you're a frequent listener to the Champion Minded podcast, we had an episode on prepper readiness. What is prepper readiness, you ask? It is the preparation that you put in, all that preparation, your practices, and the coming together of being ready to compete. And that usually happens on the day of your event. So having a routine to your competition day. For example, the time you wake up, the breakfast you have, the kind of warm-up you have, what time you arrive to the venue, that routine that happens before you go out to compete. This is something the best performers in the world have. And, you know, if I look further and further down, competitors, the lesser ability, lesser skill they have, you'll also find that they have lesser ability to be consistent in their preparation, to be consistent in their warm-ups, to be consistent in the things that are going to help them compete well and be at a higher level. And especially in the prepper readiness routine, you'll find that the top performers, an hour before they compete, have a certain routine, what they do. For example, an hour before, they might have their last snack or their last meal. 50 minutes before, they might have a shower. 30 minutes before, they get into their competing clothes. They check their equipment. So there's like almost like a countdown scale to what they do before they go out to compete. So number one, they have a prepper readiness routine. Number two in what the champion-minded performers have is they have winning routines and rituals. And you'll see when they compete that they do certain things, or they have certain, if what you like, superstitions, if you wish, when they're out there. So if I just have to have a look at golf, for example, the way a player steps up to the tee before they drive, the amount of practice swings they take, the position of their body. They might even wiggle the hips a little bit. If we look at tennis, what the players do in between the points, those 20 seconds, how they use those. Some of them might walk to the back fence, play with their strings. We know that Maria Sharapova, for example, pumps her fist, talks to herself a lot. So they have all these rituals and routines in between points or in between plays, for example. This is what the best performers have. Why do these help? Because they put you in a better frame of mind. They help you stay in the process, in the moment, which is so important. And of course, it decreases anxiety when you have rituals and routines. So that's the second thing, and what champion-minded performers have when they compete are rituals and routines. Number three, they have a game plan. They've done a little bit of homework about their opponent or their opponents. They've maybe watched video or they've scouted them at competitions. You know, one of the things I've found some of the best competitors and players do, they're maybe not as highly skilled, but they go to work. They do their homework. You know, they're sitting on the side with a notebook taking notes on their competitors. They're watching their competitors. They want to know what their strengths and their weaknesses are. You know, this is something that is a controllable. It doesn't take skill to do the homework. And something I tell athletes and players is don't expect your coach to do that. Because, you know, down the line, what if you leave your coach or vice versa? Your coach leaves you and you haven't prepared and you haven't done that homework. So they all have a game plan. They know what to do. They know what their opponent's strengths are. They know what their opponent's weaknesses are. Also, another thing that the champion-minded have is that they have a game plan to their day. They have structure to their day. They take charge of the day and not their day take charge of them. They have a wake-up time. They have time for breakfast, what time they leave home, so they're going to be well on time before practice or whatever meeting they're going to. They have structure throughout their day with their practices. They have structure throughout their day for their nap, their nutrition, all these things. They are well planned. So they have a game plan to their day. That was number three. Number four, they fuel for it. They hydrate consistently throughout the day. They understand that hydration is an all-day thing, not just sometimes thing, and not just before your competition. You know, waking up in the morning, understand that your body is already in a dehydrated state. Because you're sleeping and you haven't maybe had fluid and liquid throughout the night, and your body is under a blanket which is warm. So you're dehydrated already when you wake up in the morning. Another reason why I give my athletes the advice and the clients I consult, even in corporate world, of have a glass of water first thing in the morning when you wake up. Okay, they fuel for it. They're prepared in their nutrition. They have a great breakfast. They make sure they're getting the right amount of protein throughout the day, so protein shakes, for example. They come prepared to practices. They come prepared when they travel. They come prepared wherever they go. They live like champions. They live for what they do. That is what the high performers do. They don't rely on airport food or food on the road, stopping at the 7-Eleven or the gas station on the way to somewhere to get food. They prepare for it. And one of the bits of advice I give to athletes is, on a Sunday afternoon, is prepare your meals, prepare your food for the week. You know, do your shopping, do your grocery shopping, and do your preparation. And if you've ever, maybe you might know someone that competes in bodybuilding or in figure competitions, you'll know how disciplined they are in their diet and nutrition, and you'll see that they prepare their meals usually on a Sunday, you know, into Tupperware boxes, into they store it in the fridge for the week, and they, you know, when they leave the home in the morning, they just take that out of the fridge. So being prepared in those areas. Remember, it's always good to learn from other sports, other industries. Be open-minded. That is, again, another key thing that champion-minded performers do. And number five, they have a winning mindset. Their self-talk is powerful because confidence comes from being prepared, putting the time in, practicing, knowing you're prepared. But from there on, it's what you say to yourself, especially getting closer to the competition. even if the champion-minded aren't 100% prepared. Maybe they've had an injury, maybe they've had illness, maybe there's been some disruption in the program, they will still have winning self-talk. And this might sound arrogant, but a champion-minded performer, even if they're 80% prepared, they still have 100% belief in their capabilities. They believe they can succeed against anyone they compete against. That is not cockiness. That is confidence, inner self-confidence. They are going to give it their best. Champion-minded performers never quit. They never give in. They always back themselves no matter what the odds. In fact, just watching a World Cup soccer game last night between Belgium and Japan, Belgium being 2-0 down with 25 minutes to go, came back to win 3-2. That is a champion-minded performance. Players that believed that they would still succeed. You could see it in their body language. You could see it in their attitude. You could see it in their energy. You could see it in their communication, the way they were communicating with each other. These are champion-minded traits, especially in a team environment. But here's the thing. What if you're an individual sports athlete in tennis or golf or badminton or squash or whatever it may be? How you speak to yourself is the key element to how you're going to perform. Let me tell you one thing. Attitude is everything. And especially when things aren't going well. Because everybody's good when things are going well, but who are you when things are going bad? That is the key element of a champion-minded performer. Is no matter what, you believe you can still succeed. And you know, even if you know we can't win all the time, but even if you come off that field, that court, that track, wherever it may be, defeated, what did you learn? What did you learn from the failure? What did you learn from the mistakes? And there's satisfaction in knowing that you gave it your all. Okay, that if you can come off and know that you gave it your all, yes, you're disappointed by the loss or the defeat, but there's satisfaction in knowing you could have not have done more. And that's what you want to come off feeling. That is a champion-minded mentality, a champion-minded mindset. Self-talk is key. The words that you say to yourself, get rid of negativity. Stay positive, be your greatest coach, your greatest supporter, your greatest motivator. So, those are the five keys to a champion-minded performance in competition. Run through those again once more for you. Number one, have a prep readiness routine. Number two, have routines, rituals, build good habits. Number three, have a game plan, not just to competition, but to your day as well. Number three, fuel for it, hydrate and properly fuel. Remember what I spoke about, preparation. Prepare your foods. Don't just take a chance and hope that the right foods are going to be in the restaurant or at the airport or whatever it may be. And number five, a winning mindset, the way you talk to yourself. And those are the five keys to a champion-minded performance in competition. So guys, that's it for this week's show. Thank you for joining me once again. I'm heading back to Florida, as I mentioned before the show. It's been a great few weeks here in Europe. But thank you again to all those who have subscribed on iTunes, and also it's available on YouTube on the Champion Minded channel. Also, thank you so much for the tweets and the messages on social media. Just a reminder, I'm on Twitter, at Allistair McCall, Facebook, McCall Method, Instagram, Be Champion Minded. And I really appreciate the tweets, the retweets, the posts with the books and quotes and so on. I really, really appreciate that. And I hope that these podcasts and, of course, the books have helped you on your journey to excellence in sports and life. So that's it for this week. I hope you join me next week. Wherever you may be, have a good one. And remember, you were made for greatness. Now go do the work.